Good morning all. Today we are going to discuss two special logic circuits that are commonly used in the digital systems. They are exclusive OR gate, exclusive NOR gate and their applications. So let us start with exclusive OR gate. So this is also called as exclusive OR gate or simply written as XOR gate. So this is sometimes called as modulo 2 adder or half adder, because it adds the two numbers in the modulo 2 form. So what is modulo 2 form? Other things we are going to see in the half adder circuit, as well as I will explain briefly here also. The symbol for this is given by this. It is a OR gate which having one more curve in the beginning. So this will be A, B. So the output will be represented by A exclusive OR of B. It is given by the symbol plus inside a circle. So this will be equal to A bar B plus AB bar. So that is for the case of two input gate. So let me explain you using what output it gives. So my output can be 00, 01, 10 and 11. So when my input, both the inputs are 0, the output will be 0. When one input is 1, then output will be 1. So in this case also it will be 1. When both the inputs are 1, it will become equal to 0. That means it will give the output in such a state that output will be equal to 1 only when odd number of inputs is equal to 1. When odd number of inputs is equal to 1, in that case it will be 1. Practically only two input XOR gates will be available. If you want to get multiple input XOR gate, you have to combine these things in series and parallel combinations to get the things. Series combinations you can use, or as a set you can use them. So now in this case you can see here the output is becoming 1 when A is equal to 0, B is equal to 1, or A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 0. So A is equal to 0. So if you want to take the product, then make it 1. So you have to take it as A bar. So that's why I have written this as A bar B and A multiplied by B bar. You can see here when both inputs are 0, so product will become equal to A bar into B will become equal to 0. Similarly, A into B bar will be equal to 0. Same thing is the case when both the inputs are 1. So let us see what will be the electrical equivalence of this. So electrical equivalence of this I can represent in this form. So I am taking a battery which is equal to V. So this positive terminal, let us assume this I am taking as the input. So this one I am taking as a short lead like this. This taking a short lead. So this is my input B. This is, let us assume this is my input A. So this is 0 and this will be taken as 1. That means when switch is closed, it will be on the top one. So here this will be my switch A and this will be my switch B. Getting it? So this will be connected to a bulb like this. This is bulb, this is my output. So you can see here the bulb will be on only when one terminal is connected to positive, another terminal negative. That means when the A is connected to 1, B should be connected to 0. Under that case it will work. Or otherwise, when A is connected to 0, then B should be connected to 1. So the B should be connected to the second one. So in that case only it will switch on, or it will operate only when both the inputs are dissimilar. So that is the meaning of this. Let us try to implement this using other logic gates. So we know the value of Y or the output is A bar B plus A B bar. So let us see how to implement this. So I am taking two inputs. I have taken an input A, I have taken an input B. So I have taken a bubble or the NOT gate of this. Sorry, here I have to make the change. So here I am taking an AND gate. So this will become equal to A bar. Let us assume from here I have tapped it, I have taken B. So this is B. So this will become A bar B. So similar way, I can take the second gate. So second gate I want A B bar. So second one I want. So I have to take the bubble for B. So I have taken the bubble and this is connected to this one. And A I am tapping from here. So this A I have given here. This is A, this is B bar. So now I want the addition of these two. Addition can be obtained using an OR gate. So this will become A bar B plus A B bar. So in this way I can implement using other gates. So this is nothing but equal to A exclusive OR of B. So let us go back to this and try to analyze this. So this circuit can be used as a controlled inverter. controlled inverter. What is the meaning of the controlled inverter? I can control whether my input should be inverted or not. So let us take for example, I am using the A as my controlling signal, B as my input signal. So you can see whenever B is equal to 0, output is coming 0 when A is equal to 0, then output is coming as 1. So when B is equal to 1, A is equal to 0, in that case it is coming as same. Or otherwise, when A is equal to 0, then output is the copy of whatever is the input. So B is my input here. So B is copied to your output. When A is equal to 1, the B is copied in the opposite directions, or B is inverted. That means I can, by controlling or deciding the value or fixing the value of A, I can decide whether my input should be inverted or not. Whether my input should be inverted or not. So you may not be getting this. So let us take for example. So this is my exclusive OR gate. So this A is my controller. So this B is my input. So this Y will be equal to, Y will be equal to B bar when A is equal to 1. And Y will be equal to B when A is equal to 0. Because this again we can prove from the diagram. So let me just draw from this A, B and Y. We have seen there 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. So when it is 0, 0 output is 0, 0, 1 output is 1, 1, 0 output is 1 and second case it is 0. You can see in this case when A is equal to 0, output is copied and V is equal to 1, it is inverted. So same thing we got. So this can be used as a controlled inverter circuit. There is one more application of this. This can be used for comparing the two inputs. Well, let us assume when there are two inputs and I want to know whether two inputs are same or not. When both the inputs are same, it will give the output as 0. When the both the inputs are different, it will give my output as 1. So this is mainly used in image processing and signal processing applications where you want to compare two signals. Only if both the signals are dissimilar, give the output as 1. So this is particularly used in the case of image processing where we use for detecting the edges in an image. Where two dissimilarities are there in the image, it will be used for detecting those things. So it is used there, and it is also applied in the case of binary wavelet transform where they use the same operation, that is exclusive OR operation. So I hope the exclusive OR is clear to you. So next, let us go to the next gate. Next gate is exclusive NOR gate. So exclusive NOR gate, the output is nothing but exclusive NOR. It is just opposite to the OR gate, or we can tell that the output is opposite to this XOR gate. So remaining all will be same. So this is represented by XOR gate with a bubble at its output. So if you are giving the input as A and B, your output will be A exclusive or B whole bar. A exclusive of B whole bar. Let us see how to represent or how to implement this. So for that, let us go to the truth table. So I can represent this as A can get 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1, right? So this is just opposite to exclusive OR gate. When it is 0, 0, we got an exclusive OR as 0, here it will be 1. When both are dissimilar, in XOR gate we got 1, here it will be 0, and this will be like this. And this also, practically only two input XOR gates will be there. But if you want to get the multiple inputs, then we have to go for the combination of the XOR gates to get this combination of exclusive NOR gates. So in this case of exclusive NOR gate, the output variable will be 1. The output will be equal to 1 when odd number, sorry, it is not odd number, even number of zeros are there, or zero number of zeros are there. That means whether there is a zero number of zeros or even number of zeros, in that case output will be equal to 1, otherwise output will be equal to 0. That is the basic thing of this gate. So let us try to see what is the logic in this gate. You can see here the output when A and B are same, or A and B are same, that means both are 0, 0 or 1, 1, output is becoming 1, otherwise it is becoming equal to 0. That means when both are same, it is becoming equal to 1. When both are different, it is becoming equal to 0. So this is nothing but, so when 1, 1 is there, it will give the output when you just make the product of AB. And when 0, 0 is there, output will come when you multiply A bar with B bar. So it can be implemented like this. So this can be implemented in this form. Take a NOT gate, take another NOT gate. This is my A, this is my B. So this is given as input to A AND gate. So this become A bar dot B bar. So second one, I am taking another AND gate. So where I have given the input B and input A is given as another input. This becomes A dot B. So I have to take the addition of these things. I can take an OR gate. This will become A bar dot B bar plus A dot B. This is my exclusive NOR gate implementation. So I hope this is completely clear to you. So this exclusive NOR gate is used as a comparator. The comparator will give an output 1 only when both the inputs are same. So you can see here, when both the inputs are same, the output is giving as 1. So, and second application of this is, this can be used as an inverter only when one of the input is connected to 0. So you can see here, when A is equal to 0, in that case the output is inverted. When A is equal to 1, output is copying my input. That means if you want to use this as an inverter, just connect my input A, that means this exclusive NOR gate, this input A is connected to ground, then whatever B is there, the output will be equal to B bar. This A should be connected to ground. In that case, this will act as an inverter. I forget to draw the IC diagram for the case of exclusive NOR gate and exclusive OR gate. So that's why I am drawing the IC diagram here. I am sorry. So exclusive OR gate, the IC circuit or IC diagram will be 7486 IC is used. If you are taking the bubble here, then it will have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 pins will be there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And similarly, this will be 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. So this is given to VCC or plus 5 volts, pin number 14. Always pin number 7 is connected to ground. So inside it will be connected like this. This exclusive OR gate will be there. So pin number 1 and 2 will be connected. So similarly, another exclusive OR gate will be there. 4 and 5 will be connected as input, 6 will be output. Similar is the case here. There is one more exclusive OR gate here. This is one input, this is another input. And similar is the case here, another exclusive OR gate. Pin number 13 and 12 are the input, and 11 will be my output. This IC number is 7486. Whereas in the case of exclusive NOR gate, the construction is little bit of different inside. That IC number is 74266. So again, this will have the same number, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 and 14. So I am just keeping the number. So again, this 14 is connected to VCC or plus 5 volts, 7 is connected to ground. So inside, the connection will be done like this. So this will have the exclusive NOR gate like this. And here it will be connected in opposite direction. It will have a like exclusive NOR gate like this. So similar is the case here. Here also these two will be the inputs. One exclusive NOR gate will be here. So here also there will be a bubble input. So exclusive NOR gate will be connected like this. So this is the IC diagram for this. I hope these basic logic gates and everything are completely clear to you. If you still have any queries, you can leave your comments in the comment section below. Next class, we are going to see the Boolean algebra. Thank you. Thank you very much.